What's happening, Captain? Brother Keith. Hold the line. Grace and peace. Grace and peace. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing. Hit the subscribe button. Leave a comment. Or unsubscribe. However you feel about this message that I'm about to talk about, man. Which is the landscape here in America. And so many mouth-confessing Christians. And I'm talking to myself a few years ago, you know. I was so deceived and wrapped up in a God that I had formed into my own mind. You know what I mean? I warped who God truly was by not being into the orthodoxy of the Bible. I was into what I felt like God should be. And I would pick and choose different scriptures of what I would lean on. And I was under a denomination, charismania is what I like to call it, where they tell you God doesn't test you. He wants you to live your best life, and he wants you to live it abundantly. And that's a lie straight from the devil. That's another gospel. And I don't care how good you think that preacher that's up there that preaches that, that gives you a little bit of truth and then pitches you a huge lie like that. That's a wolf. That's who Paul was talking about in Timothy. You know, the war is in the mind, man. The war is the battlefield. Deception. And that's what Satan does. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. The great deceiver. The accuser of the brethren. And if we look at the landscape here in America and how the churches really are, you know what I mean? Over emotion, you know. Seeker friendly. On another side, you got people that have been talking about revival for so many years. All spirit, no truth. No orthodoxy. Just deceiving the masses. You understand me? So I praise God for YouTube that I can come on a platform and just be little old me. And know that the Spirit of God is going to get this message to touch somebody that really needs to hear it. I don't care if this only gets 30, 40, 50 views. There's going to be somebody in there that this touches that makes them turn from that false gospel, that all spirit, no truth, that live your own life, live your best life now, heresy, and turn and crucify yourself with Christ. Christ crucified. That's what we preach. And Paul told us about this back in the first century. There's a false gospel coming. There's a false gospel that's gonna promise you that you can live life however you want. And do whatever you want to do. And seek all your pleasures. And you don't have to deny yourself. Be crucified every day on a daily basis. Lord, not my will, let your will be done, Lord. Living for the Lord, not the world. All your little miraculous plans that you have can never trump God's plan. And you're selling your children short. You understand me? One of the greatest deceptions we got going on. You know, I heard John Piper talking about this. He's got a famous sermon where he talks about retirement. And you know, how people just, they live their life because they're carnal. The carnal person looks at things and they say, okay, you got to get the job. Okay, you got the job, you know, and the carnal mind tells us to get secure. And yeah, let's save for retirement and let's put all our eggs in this basket here so maybe we can give some money to our children. When we ain't even thinking about giving them the gospel so they can have eternal life. It's death. Listen here, man. What I want for my daughter, I want her to plant the flag of Christ on top of a mountain where nobody's even heard Christ before. That's what I want for my daughter. I don't care nothing about schooling. I don't care about none of that. Because it don't matter at the end of the day. School's a lie. I mean, look what they're teaching her children today. It's all just a great deception. And we have to be bearers of the truth. We have to we have to labor in this thing and continue moving forward. And it hurts at times because people fall away from the faith, or people that you think are born again, actually you see them in operation, you see they're not born again. They haven't buried the old self and came out new. Not saying that we don't fall short, man, because we fall short. But there's going to be repentance. There's going to be sorrow. There's going to be a turning away from how you used to be, and a burying of old self and turning to the things of God. And, you know, I walk around the world and I see the streets, and I'm in the streets every day, and I see people just consumed with themselves, just self-intoxicated, drunk, kind of like the like God made the people in Jeremiah, just drunk with self, ears closed to God. You know, now the world's back open, people are running around and just living for self. Nothing else matters but them. And I cry and I yearn for them because I was once them. And now the things that God's sensitive to, I'm so sensitive to. You know, something as I thought was innocent, like, oh, a woman can dress however she want to dress. Now I'm at the gym and I'm seeing ladies that ain't even 18 years old yet, dressed like strippers. Prostitutes is what they would be years ago. Now, all that's thrown out of the window, and just live your best life now. Live for you. Do what makes you happy. Sad. It's sad. It's sad, man. I just wanted to vent a little bit. Let's pray for this world. Let's pray for the unsaved, that they will get this gospel and they will turn from the old ways and be made new again through the blood of Christ Jesus. Hold the line. Woo!